Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to today's lunchtime concert, the last in this academic year. Lots of other events coming up in the next few days, most of which are listed on the back of your programmes, one of which isn't. At 2:15 in St. Salvator's Chapel, there will be a very interesting talk on music in the Rosslyn Chapel by Hester Greatrix, an illustrated talk with some singing and some instrumental music. So if you're free at 2:15, do just turn up to the chapel to hear that talk. Lots of other events, as I mentioned, I won't list them all, but Joanna McGregor, one of the world's leading pianists, will be here on Friday night. So if you haven't already got your ticket for that, please do so soon, because they're going extremely quickly. Great pleasure once again to welcome several student performers to give this lunchtime concert. Some of them are preparing for recitals as part of their degree next week, so this is a great opportunity for them to try out their performances to a sympathetic audience. Please would you give a warm welcome to the first performers in today's programme, Arabella Palmer and Oisin Lyons. Thank you.
Good afternoon. It's so nice to see you all. My name is Oisin, and this is Arabella. And today we're going to be starting off by performing the first two movements of Grieg's third violin sonata. Now, Grieg, of course, is perhaps most well known for the Peer Gynt Suite, among other works. But he did also compose several sonatas for various different instruments, including three for the violin, of which, of course, this is the final one. It was written between 1886 and 1887, taking a period of several months to complete, which at the time was significantly longer than his first two violin sonatas, which were both finished in just a matter of weeks. Now, not only is it the final violin sonata that he wrote, it's also, in fact, the final piece of chamber music and the final piece written in sonata form that he composed, which makes it have quite an interesting, significant place in his repertoire. Grieg himself was a Norwegian of Scottish descent, which is kind of interesting. And over the course of his lifetime, he was a very strong supporter of Norwegian independence from Sweden. And a lot of this nationalistic sentiment and pathos comes across very strongly in most of his music, in particular, in fact, the second violin sonata, but also the one that you're about to hear as well. Now, this you know, lifelong desire for independence and freedom perhaps goes some way in explaining the kind of tragic, brooding tone that's present throughout a lot of the third violin sonata. However, despite this, there are also many moments of great triumph and heroism, primarily in the first movement, whereas the second movement is a lot more serene and lyrical. Finally, another interesting fact is that during the debut performance of this piece, Grieg himself actually played the piano. And despite its somewhat somber tone, it was apparently extremely popular from the get-go, both with musicians and audiences. And that remains the case until today, being one of his most listened to and performed pieces. So we really hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Greece. I'm sure many of you are familiar with the musical, but this piece is sung by Rizzo, who is the head of the Pink Ladies and has quite a tough demeanor. And so this piece meets her at a point when she's finally like breaking down that wall. There are worse things I could do than go with a boy or two. Even though the neighborhood thinks I'm trashy and no good, I suppose it could be true.
Today we'll be playing Schubert's Piano Trio in E-flat major, opus 100. We'll be playing the first and second movements, the Allegro and the Andante con moto. I hope you enjoy. Thank you. shameless plug, I'm going to be performing this piece as part of my third year music module recital next Tuesday, so if you want to come along, you're very welcome to. So this piece is Gate. It's by Graham Fitkin, who is an English post-minimalist composer. This piece was inspired, apparently, by Boulez and Stravinsky. It's an absolute assault on the senses, so I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.